Okay, I hope you can see my screen.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's start with sum number three. Sanjana has invested ₹25,000 in a scheme, 12% per annum, compounded quarterly. Find out what will be the amount at the end of 2 years. See, whenever they tell you at the end of 2 years, 1 year, at the end of 4 years, it means they are asking you future value. Understood? It's an understood. I mean, it is understood that because they are asking you for the future period. At the end of 2 years means after 2 years. After 2 years, what it will become? Together with the interest, how much you will earn. So, therefore, we have to apply the formula of future value. Okay. Now, very important is, it is given as, Sanjana Limited has invested ₹25,000 in a scheme at the rate 12%, very important, next word, compounded quarterly. Now, whenever it says compounded quarterly, what do you mean by quarterly? Can anybody tell me?
Quarterly, three months ka hota hai, to 1 year mein four.
Ma'am?
Yes,
very good. Four month ka hota hai na?
No, 3 months ka hota hai. Dekho, ek quarter, quarter matlab 3 months. Quarter means 3 months. So you have 12 months in all. If you take first 3 months, that is one time. You take another 3 months, total 6 months, another time, that is second time. Another 3 months become 9 months, third time. And another 3 months, the last slot, which is fourth time, and it makes the total of 12 months. So if you take 3, 3, 3, 3, 4 times, only then it will become 12 months. I hope I am clear to you all. Yes? Yes?
Yes,
okay. So when you take, yes. So when you take 4 times, 3 months, it will become quarterly. It will become 12 months. So quarterly means 3 months. But I want it for 12 months. I want to convert it for per annum. Always remember, the interest has to be calculated as per annum. Therefore, if you want to calculate it for per annum, you have to check compounded half yearly, then you have to multiply it with 2. If it is compounded quarterly, you have to multiply it 4. 4, why 4? Why 4? Because 3 months are divided in 4 times, no? You will have to multiply 3 with 4. And then you will get 12 months per annum. Okay. So tell me, what is the formula of future value? PV bracket 1 plus R raised to N. This is the formula. Now, if I ask you what was present value, can you tell me what is present value?
25,000.
In the question, yes. In the question, the present value is 25,000. Okay. And now, what is the rate of interest? 12%. So in the bracket, we need to write 1 plus R. R is 12%. So we will write 12% or we have to convert. Yes. So it has to be converted. We don't have to write 12%. We have to write 12% divided by 100. What is that? 0.12. That is what we have to write. So that is 0.12. Okay. So now you tell me, how many number of years you are investing for? How many number of years you are investing for? Look at the question. What will be the amount at the end of 2 years? That means you are investing for 2 years. You are investing for 2 years. Okay. But now it is compounded quarterly. That means it is to be multiplied by 4, 2 into 4. 2 years into 4 times. Each year 4 times, no? Quarterly matlab 3 months. So you have to convert quarterly into a complete whole year. To convert quarterly into whole year, you have to multiply a year into four. Multiply year with 4. But we have 2 years to invest for. Therefore, 2 into 4. Are you getting my point? If you would have invested for 1 year, you would have done it 1 into 4. But now you are investing for 2 years, no? So 2 into 4. So outside the bracket, if it is 2 into 4, inside the bracket, it becomes divide by 4. To what divide by 4? 0.12 divide by 4. So this is the way you have to construct the formula and put up the values. So first 25,000 same. Okay. Now tell me 0, 1 plus same. Huh? I have written 1 plus same. Now you tell me 0.12 divide by 4. What is that?
0.03.
Inside the bracket, huh? 0.03. How did you calculate this? 0.12 divided by 4. 0.12 divided by 4. What is 4? It is 4 times of 3 months. Only then it becomes 12. No, 12 months means per annum, and we want it for per annum. Okay, so 0.03 is the answer of 0.12 divided by 4. And what should be the outer? What should be in the
8
on the outside of the bracket? 2 into 4. What is 2 into 4? 8. What is 2 into 4? 8. And it should be raised to 8 on the outside of the bracket. It should be raised to 8. Okay. Now let's keep 25,000 same. Until we solve the bracket, 25,000 will be same. So can you tell me 1 plus 0.03 is what?
1.03.
Very good. It is just an addition inside the bracket. 1 plus 0.03. Raised to what? Raised to what?
8.
So what you have to do in Calci, I will teach you a shortcut method. I will teach you a shortcut method now. Wait, look at the screen. I will tell you. Don't do anything. 25,000 same multiplied by, now multiplied by what? Multiplied by, take up the Calci. Take up your Calci. Do whatever I'm saying. Follow me. 1.03. You want it for 8 times. Can you see the bracket? 1.03 outside the bracket raised to 8. That means you want 1.03 8 times. Don't keep it multiplying 8 times. No, there is a shortcut method in your Calci. I will teach you that. Follow to what I say. Put the value in your Calci, 1.03. Multiply. Press the multiplication button. Multiply again, 1.03 equals 2. Now tell me what is appearing before, what is appearing on the screen of Calci?
1.06
something, no? Wait. This is the second year's figure. Ma'am, how this is second year's figure? Because you have multiplied it 2 times, no? 1.03 into 1.03, yes? And you have pressed equals to. You have already pressed equals to. That means 1.03 is twice multiplied. It is multiplied twice. It is 2 times. 1.069 is 2 times of 1.03. It is double of 1.03, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so put it again. 1.03 into 1.03 equals 2. So answer is something on your screen of Calci. Okay. Now, you don't have to keep pressing into 0.13 into 0.13. What you have to do, just press equals to multiply. Equals to multiply. Do it 7 times. So, did you understand how to do it? Should I repeat once again? See, I'll repeat for those who did not understand. 1.03 into 1.03 equals to, you have done up to here. Now don't do anything. Do whatever I say. Into, press the sign of into, matlab equals to, oh sorry, press the sign of multiplication, and then equals to. It becomes third year. See, the answer has come, the answer which has come on the screen is of the third year. Again press into, again press equals to. It is of fourth year. Again equals to, again, sorry, again multiplication, again equals to. There it will come for fifth year. Guys, are you following me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So again press multiplication ka button and then equals to.
Yes, ma'am.
Sixth. This will be of fourth or fifth or sixth maybe. So please you guys now calculate as per 8 years. See, how many times you have to press equals to, equals to, equals to? 7 times. Because eighth time nahi karna hai aapne. Dekho, jo 1.03 into 1.03 tha na, uska jo answer aata na 1.06 wo second year ka tha. Wo second year ka tha. Wait, let me also calculate. Aapke saath saath mein answer batati hu. Do it once again with me. Do it. Take up your calci. 1.03 into 1.03. Press equals to. Answer is 1.0609. Now again.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. This is second year. The answer is of second year. Now keep saying that way. Huh? This is second year. Into equals to third year. 1.125. Into equals to fourth year. 1.26. Into equals to fifth year 1.60, into equals to sixth year 2.57, into equals to seventh year 6.63, into equals to eighth year
43.97.
No, the answer 43. Is wrong. No, the answer is wrong. Just press equals to, don't multiply it. You have already put the sign of multiplication once, no? So you don't have to put it again and again. What you have to do is 1.03 into 1.03. Press equals to, that is second figure, second year's figure. Press only equals to, don't press multiplication ka button. Go on pressing equals to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is it 1.26?
1.26.
Yes. So this is what we want. Yes, 1.27 banana padega. Yes, very good. 1.27 banana padega. Okay, see, look at the screen. There is a solution which is available. See, 1.03 8 times. And they have given 1.26677. But we will take up to how many digits?
2 digits.
Yes,
two digits.
Two digits. That means how much it comes to? 1.27. Yes. I repeat, how did we do it? Put it, use your calci. 1.03 into 1.03. And the second year answer is, this is second year's answer, 1.0609. Now keep pressing equals to and go on saying third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. How many times you have pressed equals to? Total 7 times. But you have to start saying 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Until you complete 8 times, you have to keep pressing equals to. 8 times means you have to start with 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because 1.03 into 1.03, the answer which was reflected on the screen of the calci was, it was for the second year. So you have to start pressing equals to, saying third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Keep saying this. Otherwise it will get confused. I mean, you all will get confused. Therefore, the final answer of eighth year is 1.27. Now, did you guys understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure, you have all have understood.
Yes, ma'am.
ऐसा में हम लोग पहले भी तो किए थे प्रेजेंट वैल्यू में.
हाँ, वैसे ही करना है, बट उसमें हमने डिवाइड किया था ना, 1/(1+r)^n. So it was a division.
Yes, ma'am.
This is multiplication. It is a shortcut method in the calc. Did you guys understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is the final answer, please?
31,750.
Ma'am, rupees 31,750.
Very good, Shubham. Rupees 31,750. So please let me know if anybody, anything is not, I mean, if anybody has not understood, let me know. Is this clear with everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let us take a next answer, next question. A deposit of 10,000 rupees is made to earn interest, 12% per annum. Find out the future value of this deposit. Compounding period is annually. If the compounding period is half yearly, if the compounding period is quarterly, if the compounding period is monthly, and if it is daily. And if it is daily. Daily aata nahi exam mein, kyunki daily matlab 365 days. तो आपको रेस टू 365 लिखना पड़ेगा. मतलब कैलसी में 365 टाइम्स इक्वल्स टू इक्वल्स टू इक्वल्स टू इक्वल्स टू बोलते बोलते ही भूल जाएंगे. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 365 टाइम्स. और अगर आएगा बिना ये डेली तो आपको वो रेस टू का जो वैल्यू है ना, वैल्यू वो दिया जाएगा ब्रैकेट में. ओके, सो एनुअली, हाफ ईयरली, क्वार्टरली, मंथली, डेली, फाइव डिफरेंट केसेस आर देयर. And we have to solve each of them. Okay, so how we will be doing it, I will tell you. Wait, I'll tell you. Okay, the formula of future value is present value bracket 1+r^n. I hope you understand this formula and remember also. Please mute everybody. Mute Jayashree, become mute now. You have remembered the formula, I hope, where FP is future value, okay, PV is present value, R is rate of interest, N is number of years. Now, according to my sum, what is the present value? 10,000. Present value is 10,000 already given in the question. What is the rate of interest? 12%. So 0.12 is already correct. Okay, 1+0.12 is already used inside the bracket. They say find out the future value of this deposit if the compounding period is annually. So this is the first case. Wait, this is A. See, they have given A, no, as A B C D E. So we are solving as per A. We are solving as per A case. Okay. Now see. It is annually. Annually means we don't have to do anything. I mean, we don't have. I mean, we will neither divide inside the bracket. We will neither. Nor it has to be multiplied outside the bracket. So nothing, a plain formula, just like we have done sum number one, the plain formula. Nothing has to be multiplied outside the bracket, neither it has to be divided inside the bracket. So nothing, annually means it is annually. Okay, so now you help me out. 1+0.12 is what? 1+0.12 is what? 1.12 raised to how many years you are investing for?
One
year. Very good. You are investing for 1 year. So it is 1.12 only. So let us remove the bracket. 1.12 is for 1 year only, no? So directly we can multiply. So what is the answer of 25,000 into 1.12?
11,200. 11,200.
11,000 please repeat again.
200.
No.
Rupees 11,200.
200. Okay, sorry, ये 10,000 है ना, sorry.
आपने 20 हाँ 20.